Dear students, in this lecture, we are discussing about the working principle of light emitting diode. If you recall the previous lecture, we discussed about direct and indirect band gap semiconducting materials. If you draw a plot between the energy versus momentum vector, wave momentum vector, so this shows the maximum of the valency band and this shows the minimum of the conduction band. The electron and hole is recombined. The energy released in the form of a photon. Example for direct band gap semiconducting materials are compound semiconductors belongs to gallium arsenide, indium phosphide and some other examples. The combination of third group and fifth group elements. Whereas in the case of indirect band gap material, the maximum of the valency band and minimum of the conduction band, there are the different momentum vectors. So, if they combine, their energy release in the form of a phonon, nothing but vibrations, or in the form of a heat. The example for indirect band gap materials are nothing but silicon and germanium. So, this is a breakthrough in the semiconductor physics. We consider the carborundum is one of the crystal. They applied the forward potential, then the energy release in the form of a yellowish light. The further details they mentioned here. This is discovered in the year 1907. In the present lecture, we're discussing about what is the working principle of LED. So, to relate the properties of semiconducting material to the principle of LED, the selecting appropriate material for different emission of light in LED materials, what are the advantages of LED? And what is the emission wavelength with respect to the type of radiation? So, what is LED? LEDs are nothing but semiconductor p-n junction material which is operated in the forward bias mode. Then the energy is radiated in the form of light by means of electroluminescence. So, the emitted radiation in the range of UV visible or infrared regions of a corresponding electromagnetic spectrum. The emission of light energy, the quanta of light energy release is approximately proportional to the band gap of a semiconducting material. So, this is the symbol of light emitting diode. So, this is operated in the forward bias mode. Let us see the applications of LED nowadays. So, this is in the traffic signals as well as the watches. And some other like DRL, daytime running lights, we are using LEDs. Similarly, in the calculator, mobile phones, cameras, and this tablet, iPad. These are all the things we are using LED. Nowadays, we are using for organic light emitting diodes and AMO LED, active matrix organic light emitting diode in the present scenario. So, what are the advantages of light emitting diode? This is the light emitting diode is a smaller conducting chip rather than a filament which is used generally in incandescent lamp. So, this lifetime is 10,000 hours compared to the incandescent life of 1000 hours. The efficiency is it almost it emits maximum amount of the light. So, there is no heat and it is runs at very low voltages and nothing but lower currents. The intensity will be brighter and the cost is also very less and a solid state component. Not as a fraggle like an incandescent lamp. So, the luminescence is the process behind the light emission. The luminescence is nothing but a emission of radiation from a solid when the solid is supplied with some form of energy. So, the electroluminescence is nothing but excitation of electrons or holes in the application of an electric field. When you supply certain amount of electric field, the charge carriers get excited, they recombine. And energy released in the form of a light that is said to be the electroluminescence. In a p-n junction diode, injection of electroluminescence occurs resulting in light emission when the junction is in forward bias. So, let us refer to this particular figure. This is energy versus momentum, the minimum of the conduction band. This is the maximum of the valency band. When the electron hole is combined, the energy released in the form of a light. So, the emission of light depends upon the gap, energy gap. So, E equal to H nu, nu is equal to C by lambda. If we substitute, HCl lambda is equal to band gap. So this is the luminescence process. How does it work? So I have taken a p-type material and n-type material. N-type nothing but more number of electrons, whereas p-type nothing but measuring number of charge carriers, which is connected to the forward bias. The holes are injected into the n-type region and electrons are injected into the p-type region for more recombination. When the electron and hole is recombined, the energy released in the form of a light. So to get more number of recombinations, we are using this diode in the forward bias mode. So in the forward bias mode, the majority carriers both sides of the junction can cross the depletion region and entering the material outside. So here in the process, more number of electrons and hole is recombined, the energy released in the form of a photon. So we have to choose the voltage. We have to choose the voltage such that more number of recombinations to be taking place. So here when the electron and hole is combined, not necessarily all the transitions or recombination leads to the light. Some of the transitions are to be a non-radiative. The meaning of non-radiative means the energy is released in the form of a heat. So we have to choose a proper voltages and proper material so that more number of recombinations should be taking place. So let us look at this diagram. So I'm taking the n-type material. Here I'm taking the p-type material. The holes are maximum number of charge carriers. Electrons are the maximum number of charge carriers in the n-type. So when you apply the forward bias voltage, so the holes and electron, they injected into the p-type and the n-type. So they recombine, the energy release in the form of a light. The efficiency of the device therefore can be described. The efficiency depends upon how many number of charge carriers are going to be recombined. So the emission of wavelength depends upon the number of radiative recombinations. That is equal to EC minus EV is equal to EG. So lambda G is equal to HC by the band gap. That will give the corresponding wavelength. Let us look at one problem related to the one of the material, gallium arsenide, whose energy gap is 1.44 electron volts. So what is the emission of wavelength? So if you use this particular formula and substitute it, so Eg is equal to H nu, Hc by lambda. So Eg is 1.44 electron volts. So I'm 1.6 into 10 power of minus 19 joules. I'm using this. And H is a Planck's constant and C is a speed of light. I got the wavelength around 8628 angstrom minutes above the red color wavelength. So in short, we can use the wavelength formula lambda in terms of nanometers, 1240 by the energy gap in electron volts. That will be the corresponding wavelength in nanometers. So in the construction of typical LED, we have to take the p-type material and n-type material. So better to take the base is a p-type material and dope more number of third group elements or more number of dopant, which produces a more number of holes, and take the n-type material and dope more number of electrons so that you'll get the more number of electrons. Our target is to recombine maximum number of holes and electrons, and once the electron and hole is combined, there's emission of a photon. The photon should be reflected and the photon should be reflected and it has to come out from this. If it is not coming out from the material, so that energy is taken by some other combinations, leads to the unwanted energy in the form of a heat. So the more number of recombinations to be taken care using the p-n junction diode, suitability of the material, and the light should not be reflected within the medium, that should be transmitted from this. So so here the major remembering point is the p-n junction diode should be operated in the forward bias mode. So recombination must occur, that should be in the form of a wavelength. The direct band gap semiconductors to allow more number of recombinations. All photons created must be able to leave the semiconductor material. There is no reabsorption of photons. So we have to choose the material requirement. We have to go for direct band gap. That material can be made P and N type. So more efficient radiator recombination. So let us we choose the direct band gap materials with refractive index that could be allow the light should be moved out from the material. So if you choose at this energy 3.25 electron volts, this in the range, you will get the wavelength in this particular region. If you choose the energy gap between 3.1 electron volts to 1.6 electron volts, the wavelength comes under 450 to 650 nanometer. Similarly, we have infrared LEDs also. If you take the energy band gap is 1.65 electron volts, the wavelength should be around 150 nanometers. So you're getting the in the range of infrared region. The typical exam question in the exam, we may get this: what is the working principle of LED? Whatever materials are chosen for the more efficient LED. So the major point you have to remember is the working principle of LED is electroluminescence. The type of materials we are using for LED is direct band gap materials, and write the definition of direct band gap. So whatever materials we need, more efficiency, more recombinations. So suitability of the voltage is also important to produce more number of recombinations that should be emitted in the form of a light. And also the light should be which should not be reflected in the same medium, that should be moved out from the device. So if you let us look at this particular spectrum: violet, blue, green, yellow and orange, red. The corresponding energy gap should be 1.62 electron volts to 3.17 electron volts. That means when the energy band gap is very less, you'll get the red. The energy gap is around 3.17 electron volts, we'll get the wavelength in terms of violet. So this is the electromagnetic spectrum. In this we are going for this particular violet to blue. The violet is 400 nanometers, this is 700 nanometers. So the red color corresponds to 1.62 electron volts, the violet corresponds to 3.17 electron volts. So these are the materials as of now that discovered related to the compound semiconducting materials. So gallium arsenide, indium phosphide, they emit the different wavelengths. So this is the symbol for light emitting diode. If you keep it this line, this is said to be the laser diode. In the case of laser diode, the difference between light emitting diode and laser diode, in this case of laser diode, the stimulation process taking place, we have the reflected cavity and transmission cavity, whereas in LED we don't have the cavities. So this is the semiconductor diodes: rectifier diode, tunnel diode, a Zener diode, varioactor diode, nothing but variable capacitor, light emitting diode. This is the photodiode, which works in the reverse bias mode. This is the vanistor. So these are the different type of materials we choose for third group, and this is the fifth group elements for binary group elements. And so for these are the binary compounds, third and fifth, ternary compounds, which can use it for to emit the different color or so different wavelengths based on the energy gain. Thank you.